I too thank the noble Lord, Lord Alton, for initiating this important debate that touches the very core of our humanity, transcending all differences of color, culture, class, or creed, and setting moral limits to the use of power. It took great crises to make people aware of human rights. The wars of religion in the 17th century that led Milton and Locke to formulate the doctrine of the rights of man, proclaimed the next century in the American and French revolutions. And it was sustained reflection on the Holocaust and on the Nazi program to eliminate whole classes of humanity, the physically and mentally handicapped, homosexuals, Roma, Sinti, and Jews, that led to the great 1948 United Nations Universal Declaration of Human Rights. It was a way of saying that what happened in the Holocaust should never happen again, and that those who died should not have died in vain. And it remains a testament to the human spirit that at that time of Cold War, of tense conflict in the Middle East, the nations of the world were nonetheless able to come together in collective affirmation, whether through religious faith or human reason, of the inherent dignity and equal and inalienable rights of all members of the human family. That remains, despite the genocides and the abuses that have happened since, of which we have heard so powerfully today. That remains a signal of hope and a template of aspiration that must continue to protect us against cynicism and despair. My lords, on this vast subject, I wish to make just one point. Rights depend not only on declarations, but also on education. Rights are lost when one group within a society, usually the dominant group, sees another group as a threat to its freedom, its own dominance. Threat becomes fear, fear becomes hate, and hate becomes dehumanization. The Nazis called Jews vermin, lice. The Hutus of Rwanda called the Tutsis inyenzi, cockroaches. And when this happens, when we dehumanize the other, evil follows as night follows day. The only way to stop this is education. My lords, I am deeply concerned at the teaching of hate that exists in some parts of the world and among some groups today. That teaching is poisoning the minds of young children and other vulnerable individuals, condemning them to a future of conflict and hostility from which they themselves will lose, for hate harms the hater no less than the hated, and when I diminish others, I am myself diminished. Article 26 of the Universal Declaration speaks about education. Paragraph 2 states that it should, I quote, promote understanding, tolerance, and friendship among all nations, racial or religious groups. How good it would be if we could find ways of making that a reality and not just a pious hope. Today, as my noble lord has mentioned, is the first day of the Jewish festival of Hanukkah, the anniversary of the time 22 centuries ago when Jews fought and won their right to religious freedom. Shall we not work together, Jews, Christians, Muslims, those of all faiths, to teach the world's children to see God's image in people who are not in my image, whose color is not mine, whose language is not mine, whose faith is not mine, a principle shared, if differently expressed, by secular humanists of all kinds. For human rights begin in the way we teach our children to recognize the humanity of the other and the dignity of difference. The rights of tomorrow are born in the education of today. Amen.